Hey everyone, Battlefield 6 has just dropped and I'm really glad I've got an RTX 50 series card because I can now enable Reflex 2, which cuts my input latency by 75% and my game just feels so snappy. Okay, that's what I would be saying if NVIDIA actually released Reflex 2 like they promised they would do at the very start of this year, but instead they just haven't done that, and at the time of filming no one knows where it is. So what gives? Where is this new technology? Why is it apparently so much better than Reflex 1? And why did the Dying Light actually list Reflex 2 as a supported technology? That's what I wanted to discuss in this video, and firstly it's clear to me at least that NVIDIA have kind of dropped the ball a little bit with this Reflex launch, because when they first were hyping up for the RTX 50 series launch, they were talking of Reflex 2 as quite a big feature. They were talking how it would be in Valorant and the finals and really help input latency, so instead of it being cut by 50% it would be cut by 75%, which would be brilliant, and I know a lot of people playing FPS games were really looking forward to this technology. But obviously since then we've had no updates whatsoever. Well, actually saying that, they did give one update about Reflex 2, which was a developers conference in March, and a few people actually went to it and spoke about the experience of testing out Reflex 2, which I'll cover a bit later on in this video. But firstly, what is Reflex 2 and why am I so excited about it, or why was I so excited about it before NVIDIA just forgot to discuss it anymore? Well, Reflex is all about reducing input latency, so when you're playing a game such as Battlefield 6 or Call of Duty Blops or CS2 or Valorant or any of those games, when you move your mouse, obviously you want everything to be really responsive, and if an enemy pops up, you want to be able to move your mouse, immediately see them, aim at them, and shoot at them. That's obviously fundamental to a game, whether it's single player or multiplayer, and the idea behind Reflex is it's going to kind of optimize the graphical pipeline to improve on that experience. So effectively what happens when you move your mouse, that would send a signal to the CPU saying that something has changed, and then you'd have a render queue that would then effectively interact with the GPU, so the GPU could say, oh, something's changed, you know, the mouse has been moved, the field of view has changed, an enemy's appeared, all of that stuff, and the GPU could actually generate the relevant frames. So essentially you have that pipeline of, you know, mouse to CPU to the render queue to the GPU, and then the final frames being rendered on a monitor, and that will cut input latency, and that's obviously a really good thing, and that has worked very well. And when I play Battlefield 6, for example, I do enable Reflex because it does work well and it does cut input latency. But in my opinion, it's a pity the Reflex 2 never launched, because NVIDIA was saying it was so much better. Because a team of researchers at NVIDIA realized that that pipeline interaction between the CPU and the GPU is still going to be a little bit of a bottleneck, because ultimately the GPU is the thing that's doing all the complex calculations and rendering that ultimately generates the frames that we see every single second when playing a game. So the GPU is often the bottleneck. And so what these team of researchers seen is that, you know, if even though they can optimize the pipeline between the CPU and the GPU, that's still going to be inherently limited when you move your mouse if the GPU is waiting to do other stuff. So what Reflex 2 was trying to do, and they call it frame warp, they'd be a bit of a cheat where effectively when you moved your mouse is that some of those rendered frames would be painted on and then warped, so effectively manipulated, so that your mouse movement wouldn't have to wait for a full refresh cycle of the CPU to the render queue to the GPU. And by doing that, Reflex 2 is meant to decrease input latency by 75%. And it sounds like a pretty cool technology, and as I mentioned in the intro, NVIDIA were really sort of hyping this up in January, and then it went completely quiet. Other than in March, when there was a game developer conference and NVIDIA were there and actually flew out a bunch of journalists and YouTubers and allowed them to demo Reflex 2. And Philip done a really good video on this. You can go to the 4-minute, 28-second mark to actually see his thoughts on the linked video. But essentially what he said was that while you couldn't necessarily notice the improvement too much going from Reflex 1 to Reflex 2, there was still, you know, some sort of improvement there. And also from a visual perspective, at first he was concerned whether the graphics would be all over the place. And certainly on the edges, Philip said things were overall fairly good. However, when it came to like anti-aliasing and looking at the actual characters and where you're aiming and stuff, there were some visual glitches introduced in Reflex 2 that weren't there with Reflex 1. And I think probably that's why Reflex 2 has gone a little bit quiet. And I don't think that NVIDIA have killed it. I think they are still working on it, but I just think that it's probably quite a difficult problem to solve in order to get input latency down even more, because Reflex 1 is already very good. But what's weird is that somebody actually asked NVIDIA how to enable Reflex 2, and the person who replied, who might not be completely knowledgeable about, you know, Reflex 2 as a whole, they did seem to say that it is still being worked on, it's just not available yet, and it depends on games implementing it too, which is interesting to me, especially because the Dying Light game actually listed Reflex 2 as a supported technology, but then later quickly updated that to say Reflex 1 and said, you know, that was a mistake. But I'm not convinced that was a mistake. optimistic, because there's actually some rumors that NVIDIA might be holding it back until the RTX 50 Super Series launch. And I know that with Reflex 2, they did say that originally it would start off on the 50 series and then go to the other GPUs. But it's just interesting, we've had all these delays. And yeah, my hunch is that the reason NVIDIA have delayed it is mainly because it's a very difficult problem to solve, and it's introducing loads of graphical artifacts. You know, even in a demo, there are issues. So if you're going to have issues in a demo, what's it going to be like when you release it to hundreds and thousands of games? But in addition, I think that maybe NVIDIA are going to hold it back a little bit to coincide with the RTX 50 Super Series launch. Maybe I'm wrong, I hope I am. It would be nice if NVIDIA actually just updated people on it, or, you know, released Reflex 2 like they said they would do in January 2025. But there we are, that hasn't happened yet. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you've got any thoughts or comments though, please do leave a comment. If you enjoyed this video, please click the thumbs up button, and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.